plankton are basically responsible for all the life we see on Earth. These are creatures that provide 2/3 of our oxygen, and they're invisible.
The amount of evidence that shows the decrease of plankton life is overwhelming. There's no doubt that climate change has a big impact.
The plankton population might have decreased by as much as 40% in a half a century. As we start losing them, we start losing the fish that feed on them, which a lot of the world depends on for protein. When I was a boy, I loved taking apart my toys. And so I've learned a lot because I could see how things work. And as an engineer, I've learned how to build things by seeing how others have built by taking apart their work. Currently, I'm studying plankton and building microscopes. The initial microscope was created by me just playing around with cameras. I tried to figure out what would be good to see, and unfortunately, blood cells are too small. But it turned out plankton is the perfect size for this microscope. And so I put plankton on an imager chip, and I capture the shadows that plankton create. I gave a talk on the microscope, and Simone was in the audience, and he realized my microscope could solve a big problem he was having.
I was trying to understand how abstract little creatures could move in specific ways and interact, and how that behavior would change according to specific environmental variables. But I didn't actually have an instrument to get better data to describe the movement of these things in 3D in a more realistic way.
As we started collecting more samples from the field, it became a real hassle to take one drop at a time and put it on the imager chip. And so that led to the immersion microscope idea.
I put the microscope in the puddle of plankton.
It allows you just immediately to see how life really happens, how this ecology really lives.
Years ago, I invented the data glove and did a lot of work in virtual reality.
So I thought, wouldn't it be cool if I could move the microscope with my head and basically scuba dive with plankton?
We realized that this instrument may actually allow us to collect the data that may be necessary to understand the death of these creatures, so to figure out ways of preventing that.
The goal is to have real-time continuous monitoring of plankton in the water. It's like having a doctor follow you around 24/7.
The science that we want to make right now needs to be interdisciplinary. You cannot just be a physicist. You cannot really just be an experimental biologist. Your expertise will bring you just so far. To do the next step, you need collaboration. In order to do that, you need to have a very open mind and to challenge yourself every day. And Tom is one of these people. He's a real scientist.
With Simone, we've been studying the behavior of plankton called stentor, which is a huge single-cell organism. It's about almost a millimeter long, and it looks like an ice cream cone.
When they're unhappy, like if they're in a toxic chemical environment, they swim backwards. And when they're happy, they swim forwards. So we're looking to try and use them as chemical sensors for monitoring, for example, the quality and health of water.
We've been building these microscopes and do workshops to bring it into schools to allow kids to get a firsthand experience of life in a drop of water.
Maybe this technology will create more awareness. Seeing young people taking samples and putting them in the instrument and looking at their computer and seeing these little creatures and going, oh, it's one of the most exciting things. Maybe there's hope for the future. We look at the stars much more than we look at the oceans. And we spend billions of dollars for space exploration. A fraction of the space budget goes into studying the oceans. And there is so much that is unknown.
It's a wake-up call for us to do better stewardship of the Earth. And it starts with the health of the plankton.